Hey everybody, welcome to the Boston Microsoldering stream. I just wanted to do a quick video on a charger port here for Motorola. It's not something you're going to see too often. It's a Moto E second generation. Not too many people are going to have a dead Moto E from 2015 and decide to fix it. But this charger port, when I opened up the device, I found it is pretty common. You're actually going to see this exact same charger port in the Moto G4s, the Moto G4 Plus, where it fails all the time. This port's also common in one of the Droid Turbo phones. I think I'm going to look up compatibility a little later. And what we'll do basically is make a list of models that this matches. The thing is, this is a bit of a tricky charger port to do because the pins are trapped behind these back legs. It's a good way to give the device the part structure, but it makes it really hard to get in even with a like a micro pencil. So we're going to take off the old port with hot air. We're also going to have to put the new port on partially with hot air as well. And you know, the method that we use for this is going to be identical on those G4s and G4 Plus that you'll see a lot more often. So first we have our phone, Moto E second gen. So it certainly isn't a disassembly video. I already opened this guy up and inspected it. The screen's in fine shape. The original battery is dead. I have another battery here, which is also dead, but we just want to demo that this guy is turning on. Well, not turning on, but giving us a dead battery at least. So, and it's got just enough juice to know that it doesn't have any juice. This battery is also a little bit swollen, so I'm not really trusting that it's going to turn the device on. So this should boot. Just want to obscure any customer info that might come up. And it's already turning off. No battery. All right. Now, this was technically a case of water damage, and that I noticed just a tiny amount of corrosion by the charger port. Keep that guy safe. But the rest of the machine is really clean, and in fact, the one water damage sticker that's visible from the outside of the device is still white. A little bit of moisture got into the port itself, which may have contributed to the solder joints cracking. Let's see. We already have all of our screws and brackets out of this device. I just want to show you a close-up of what we see on the port. Okay. So see how we have our six mounting legs. Pins are back here. We have a little bit of a mineral deposit on here, so we can already be certain that liquid has been in this area, perhaps enough to, you know, slightly corrode those ports, the pins of the port. And if you look down, what we're gonna see is all five pins, maybe four out of the five pins are cracked. There really wasn't much solder in there to start with. Because there's so little material, reflowing this may make it work today, but it's just going to crack again very soon. So we definitely want to replace this with a new part, and that'll allow us to put a nice, to flow a nice bit of leaded solder in there. Also want to draw your attention to this microphone right here, which has a through hole on the front of the phone. This mic, we have to make sure we don't overheat. all of these filters and diodes here are pretty far away from the port. I'm not too worried about them, but I am worried about getting that microphone too hot. So we are gonna tape this off. Also gonna put some leaded solder on these joints before we take it off with hot air. Into a comfortable board holder. And I'm gonna tape our rear camera just so it doesn't get dusty, but there's no reason to take that camera off. We're not gonna get alcohol in that area. And it's certainly not gonna get hot. Our front camera as well can have a little bit of tape on it. Nice, easy mount. Okay, so first things first, we want to add some leaded solder to these joints to lower their melting point. Get our fume extractor on. Almost get this off with the iron. I'm going to hit it with some air from the bottom, and we'll see if we can just get that off in one piece. Maybe reclaim the original port, possibly. And this little bracket here is not part of the USB. It's just like a brace. A bit of tape to our microphone hole just in case later, you know, some alcohol or flux starts to go in that direction. It'll be safe. Nice and sealed. That's sort of in one piece. Inside's not perfect, but we are going to use a brand new part. Get off that bracket so we can clean it. Both sides clean. We're going to be removing all the material from these through holes.
very gentle with these. I'm really trying not to abrade the USB lines. Just barely touching them. Okay, so the reason we want these through holes to be perfectly clean is we actually want to flow just the USB pins to start with, and then we'll do the mount second. We want our new USB port to really be able to kind of float around for a bit until we choose to mount it in place. So this guy is just going to kind of be able to wander a little bit. Oh, and of course, we have one piece here and it has a bend from either the factory or shipment or something. So we want to very carefully pull that pin up. Forceps to hold that still. Slowly lever it. Level. Those five pins are going to sit right above the pads. What we need is for those pads to have a lot of material on them so that it flows around each pin. And I'm also going to bend three in the middle down, Yeah, just a tiny bit. A lot of material on these five pads. So we're not really going to be able to touch it up very much. Now we're going to start this with the micro pencil. Enough, we'll have to do it with some hot air to help. Here, what iPad Rehab would call puffy pillows. Now, these two puffy pillows, we would like to be as large as this one, so we're going to try covering this in flux and adding more material. If it doesn't work, there's a method we can use to just put a chunk of dried or solid solder on top of this, and then use the hot air to make it flow onto the pad. Air. fact, I may have gone slightly overboard. This one's going to bridge too much material. Hot air melting those, we're going to drop our new port down and allow it to grip each of our five copper pins. And since our holes here are totally clear, plenty of space. Finding our microphone. Okay, let's have a look, and we can reflow it if it's on straight. Well, looks like we have a bridge. So that's okay. We can go ahead and hit that center one with the micro pencil to remove some material. The most important thing is that we have a lot of leaded solder. And those center pins don't have a lot of thermal mass, so I think we can pull the material out with the micro pencil. Adding material into those joints after the fact is the difficult part. chisel tip would probably be best for this, but we don't have one at the moment. We do with what we have. Are flowed under and above the pin. Take a look at the immediate area. Not too much flux to clean up. And when we blow this with hot air, we are going to blow the flux away from the microphone. Always pushing away from the mic. So we can go ahead and flow our mounts and then put our little bracket back on the other side. Cover, drips on the table, it drips on the table. Clean. And make sure we start with fresh. crushed shell of lead. Heat the board, not the part. Heat the board, not the part. Rotate your project to make it comfortable for you. Heat the board, not the part. Now on the newer devices that use this charger port, like the Moto G4, you don't have nearly as much clearance behind the port to do these legs. It's a little trickier than this. Take a look at our other side. Solder to these pads. Something for our little bracket grip. We should just be able to put the bracket on with the iron, large iron. The bracket's just like a reinforcement. I want to clean this. It's got the burnt flux on it. Wipe a little bit of excess solder off. Not to spare on that in the process. Thank you. that's fine for the brace.
Can of air. And we're gonna have some solder, not some solder, some flux inside the port. We're just gonna address that with a toothbrush. Any chunks? Sometimes it's best to just flick those with a knife or a sharp tweezer. Blowing away from the microphone. It's a perfectly clean port. Let's take one look at our pins on the back. No bridging. Those could be float a little bit better, but I'd have to do it with hot air, and I don't really want to expose the plastic part of this port to more heat. See if we're charging. Now, we didn't check the amperage before because I knew that these pins were all broken. There was no point in testing to see if it charged. It's really just more important to see if the device turned on, which it did. heat. We will try the customer's original battery. Oh, and before I forget, we need to untape that microphone. Now, we didn't check this with the customer's original battery. We tested it with this old swollen one before, but we'll see them both. All right, 5 volts, no amps. And we're pulling nothing, pulling a quarter of an amp. Got our little charging indicator up, pulling half an amp. It's vibrating, and we're pulling an amp. So this guy is probably charging at its full speed. This is a pretty small, low-end phone with not a huge battery, so I wouldn't be surprised if it doesn't charge at more than an amp. Moto Gs, Moto Xs, Moto Zs all have Qualcomm Quick Charge. I would kind of be surprised if a second-gen Moto E does, so we're going to call 1 amp a pretty normal maximum speed. Let's check what the display says. Unplugging our battery before we plug in something that has a backlight. Screen is locked in, gate's closed. Customer's original battery is in. Five volt output from our battery. Pulling 1 amp and booting. And here we go. 4% battery. Let's see if this guy can turn on and stay on under its own power now. Just want to cover any customer information in case it pops up. Almost killed Peppa Pig. She's okay, though. Peppa's okay. And here we have it. Battery saver is on. 5%. charging. So that about does it for today. We are going to have to test our microphone just, you know, as part of a procedure, which means putting this back together, popping a SIM card in. But since we had it taped, we didn't use any hot air in the area of the microphone, and no flux got into the area of the mic, I'm very hopeful it is still in perfect condition. And just remember, you're not going to see too many Moto E second gens. No one really wants to pay to fix a $99 phone. But you are going to see this exact same broken part on G4s, G4 Plus. In fact, I personally fixed 10 G4s and G4 Pluses, this exact port, before I ever saw a Moto E second gen and realized they were the same part. Thanks for joining us, and good luck with your repairs.